Hello and welcome back to my channel. In this episode, which is the first out of a series of two, I will tell you something about mounting a tablet on a motorbike. What could be better than to have a large screen in front of you, running your favorite navigation app? Sounds ideal. And as far as I know, the bike sitting behind me, the AJP PR7, was the first bike to actually come out with a tablet, factory installed. It's a Samsung unit, and so that has been quite revolutionary. I would also like to mention the Honda Africa Twin, the latest model, the 2020 model. It actually comes out with a very nice display, and it features Apple CarPlay. So also there you are able to install your favorite navigation app. So well done, Honda. Really like it. If I mention the adventure bikes, the Honda Africa Twin and this AJP PR7 behind me, I would also like to mention the Yamaha T700. Very nice bike. Very basic bike, and obviously it does not feature a tablet or Apple CarPlay, anything like that. It does have a huge, I mean a humongous display unit, and for such a basic bike, where all you need to really see is your speed, your rev count, your fuel level, why does it need to have such a humongous display unit? I bet it's a very solid piece, but it's just huge. Because it's so huge, it doesn't provide you a lot of space anymore to mount a tablet or any other navigation device above it. Let's talk about the issues that you need to solve when you wish to mount a tablet on a motorbike. There are really two issues. So the first one is you need to physically mount that tablet with the right hardware in place. It needs to be in the right position and be stable and not rattle loose. So that's your first challenge you need to solve. And the second one is the electrical connections. You need to provide that tablet with ample power, and you need to make sure that all the plugs are solid and they don't collect any dirt and they don't rattle loose. Those electrical connections are not so easy to get stable on your motorbike, especially those little USB connectors, like the micro USB connector used on the Samsung tablet. That's a tiny, tiny little connector. Keeping that thing clean and making sure that it stays in place is pretty hard. Let's take the Samsung unit off of this bike, take it inside and have a look at it. The tablet is held in place by these two bolts and nuts. Originally there was a wing nut on the bottom. For me, this one vibrated loose and I decided to not use it again because of the risk of losing the whole tablet. So I put two self-locking nuts on here. So we loose up the electrical connector. Careful not to lose the spacers. There we go. So what we're dealing with here is a Samsung Galaxy Tab A6 that came out of this box. It's a 7-inch tablet with 8 GB of RAM on board, and the model number is SMT280. The housing is held together by 8 screws with a Phillips head. But the housing is pretty nice. It's well made, it's well put together. It works, I can tell you that. I've
I've wondered why they hadn't gone for a RAM mount or, you know, something that's already on the market. But in any case, this works. That's the last one. Let's turn around. Take the cover off. Put it aside. All right. Put it on that camera. So, what have we? We have our tablet. And our tablet is obviously wired, and it's connected by a little USB cable here with a micro USB connector. This connector, I've actually taped it to the tablet, and I had to do that because it was coming loose. It was vibrating loose, and so I've put a piece of electrical tape over the connector. So that's my advice to you if you have this same tablet with the micro USB connector on the side. Put a piece of electrical tape over it. It'll hold it in place better. So I'll take that loose now, and when I put it back, I'll put a new piece of tape over it. All right, that's my piece of tape there. And now I can take the micro USB connector out. All right, so here's our Samsung Tab. Has a camera. Cannot use the camera because it's inside the inside the box. Doesn't matter. So it's a nice device. Okay, look. One other piece of tape. There's also a piece of tape over the home button, the Android home button. It's a real hard button, and it's just to prevent you from operating that button accidentally. So the power on off and the volume buttons there, they're not taped up. They're just left. So inside, what we got is, so we have the 12 volts coming in from the bike. All right, it's gonna be a little bit more than 12 volts, it's gonna be about 13.5. That then goes to a little, it's being split up. So 12 volts goes directly to the USB the socket here, which turns your 12 volts into 5 volts, and then we have 12 volts being converted to 5 volts in here, and it goes to your little micro USB connector to the tablet. What I have had to do is to tape up this part as well, put some additional tape on here, because also that was getting vibrating loose and causing a poor connection and collecting a lot of dirt. So I put additional tape on this connector right here. That's that for the tablet. What I will do now is I'll put it back together, and I will switch it on. So now I'm going to put the micro USB connector back, cut me off a new piece of tape. So, all right. You'll see the piece of tape sticking out a bit, but it doesn't matter. All right, so put the cover on. Make sure you put the cover on in the right position, because there's a, see, this part here has been cut off for the USB wire to give some space to the USB wire. So that goes on the right side. There we go. It's in place. Let's put the 8 screws back. So I've put the tablet in the box, and I will connect up the 12 volts connector to a power supply. I'll give it a bit more than 12 volts. I'll give it 13.5. And let me switch that on now. And we can see now that it's tablet is firing up. It's booting up, and we have 0.47, so 470 milliamps of current flowing through, and so that's at 13.5 volts. If we assume that the tablet is getting exactly 5 volts, this would amount to about a little bit over 1,000 milliamps being consumed by the tablet itself. What you got in here is a rooted tablet, and there's nothing wrong with that. The only disadvantage is that you're not receiving any over-the-air updates from Google, security updates and patches. So there is no home button. You have to go via the dashboard, and if I want to open up the maps that I use, maps of me, for instance, we can go there, open up maps of me. So when I switch the bike off, and I will now just turn the power supply off, the tablet is going to say, hey, I'm not charging. Do you wish to shut down? And you can now cancel it, or press shut down now. So if I cancel it, it keeps running. The only problem I have with this is that if I now want to switch it off, I don't know how to do it. I mean, there's no off key, and I just don't know how to do that. How do I switch it off? What if I go to Maps Me, and I go back to the dashboard via the carousel? Yep, and then it will actually say, hey, I'm not charging. So you have to cancel it again or press shut down. Let me press shut down. And that's it. The tablet stops running. One last thing I would like to demonstrate to you is the external USB port on the housing here. So for that, I've rigged up a special USB cable which goes through my old Fluke multimeter to show you how many amps we can pull from this external USB socket. For that, I also use my iPad 4 mini tablet. It's the other tablet that I've had on my bike. So that likes to pull a lot of power. And so I'm going to connect it up right now to the external USB port on the housing, going through our multimeter. So this puts the multimeter in between. And there we go. So we're pulling almost 1600 milliamps from this socket, which is pretty incredible. So this is a far fast charging socket here on the housing. Really nice. 1500, almost 1600 milliamps from this socket. So anything you plug into this housing will charge your device quickly. Nice.
So that was that for the Samsung unit on the AJP PR7. Very nice piece. I really enjoyed using it, although the user interface was a bit awkward, having no home button and no on-off switch. But all in all, a very solid piece, and I think AJP did a tremendous job there. In the next episode, I will show you how I mounted the iPad on this bike. I needed the iPad to run a particular application that wasn't available on the inside the Android Play Store. So I will show you how I mounted this iPad using this hardware on this bike. That'll be in the next episode. Thank you for watching. Till the next time. Bye.